I have been crucified with Christ, and it is no longer I who live, but it is Christ who lives in me, and the life I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. And then I will bow and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. My dear friends, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contract of our Lord and mercy. You came to poor sinners, Christ have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, you willed to draw Saint Gerard to yourself from his earliest years, and to mold him to the image of your crucified Son. Grant, we pray, that following the example of his life, we may be transformed in the same image. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus said to them, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, they will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor. Now my soul is troubled, and what should I say? Father, save me from this hour. No, it is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name." Then a voice came from heaven, "I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." The crowd standing there heard it and said that it was thunder. Others say, "An angel has spoken to him." Jesus answered, "This voice has come for your sake, not for me. Now is the judgment of the world, of this world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, I will draw all people to myself." The Gospel of the Lord. The story of this man, Gerard Majella, whom we celebrate today, a Redemptorist saint, is a story of a human life. It is a human story. It is a story of one man from his childhood had a quest for God. He received the faith handed over to him by his parents, but he made it his faith. And from that moment, when God touched his life was no longer the same. He pursued for the knowledge of God and the love of God. And he could do anything so that he can live and share this love. He did not allow anything to come in the way between his holiness and his love of God and love of neighbor. St. Gerard Majella was born on the 6th of April, 1726. He was born frail. And he grew up frail, with a very frail physical appearance, but he was not frail in the faith. He had a strong faith. He did not allow what appeared outside in people's eyes to come in the way in what lied inside him, the greatness of God. He tried joining the Capuchins at a young age, around 16 and 18, but he was denied entry, because they looked at how he appeared and they said he could not fit into the religious life and system and way of doing things. So they rejected him, they shut the doors in his face. He tried again years later when he was 23 with the Redemptorists, when they come to his parish for a mission. And of course the mission superior then, the Redemptorists, looked at him and said, "You are not fit. We cannot have you." But he insisted. He persevered. And they reluctantly accepted him. And the superior sent him with a letter to another community and said, "I am sending you a useless brother." A useless brother. But they accepted him in his uselessness. But from his uselessness, he has come to be the greatest among all, for he lived his life in following the way of God. He became a wonder worker.
is known for being the patron of expected manners. For this is for the love of those who are suffering, for the love of those who are in pain, for the love of the poor. It's expressed here in his sanctuary. That's what we celebrate today. So he shows us that anyone can be a saint if we are ready to follow and do the will of God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, to become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O Lord, you accepted the oblation of your servant, Gerard, as he offered himself daily with Christ. Accept the sacrifice of our will, together with the gifts we present at your altar, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father, O powerful, ever living God. Through Christ our Lord, you are glorifying in your saints, for their glory is the crowning of your gifts. In the life of St. Gerard, you give us an example. In our communion with him, you give us his friendship. In his prayer for the church, you give us strength and protection. His witness spurs us on to victory, to share the same crown of glory through Jesus Christ, our Lord and soul. With the angels and archangels and the whole company of the saints, we sing our unending hymn of praise. Holy,
holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time of betrayal, and later during the into his passion, he took bread and gave me thanks for it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. the mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chance of salvation, giving thanks that your God has called you to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember that the church spread throughout the world and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, his spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Gerard, and all these saints who please you throughout the ages, may merit to you as we turn our life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through you, and with you, and in you, O God, Almighty God, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
The saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy may all this free from sin, and sinful motives precise we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, we say to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who go to the supper of the Lamb. but rejoice in so far as you are sharing Christ's sufferings, so that you may also be glad and shout for joy when his glory is revealed. If you are reviled for the name of Christ, you are blessed. Let us pray. O Lord, may the sacrament we have received stay up in us the desire to please you always, so that like St. Gerard, we may ever strive to do your will.